Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Hilman Tamimi from PJB Services Sidoarjo, and Mr. Prabowo is my paper professor from 10 November Institute of Technology, Surabaya. I would like to give presentation about our paper with a title Study of Non-condensable Gas Falling and Plugging Effects on Condenser Performance Using NTU-Effectiveness Analytic Method and 2D Numeric Simulation. Condenser is one of the main equipment in steam power plant that has function to condense turbine exhaust steam with cooling medium in the form of circulating water from seawater or river water. Condenser performance degradation affects to plant efficiency and power output degradation. There are several factors that can cause condenser performance degradation. Three of them are non-condensable gas, falling, and plugging. The objective of this paper is to compare variation in the percentage of non-condensable gas, falling thickness, and amount of plugging so that we can find out how significant and how sensitive the effect of this variation on condenser performance, power output, and financial losses. NTU effectiveness method is a method to determine the effectiveness of heat exchanger in transferring a certain amount of heat. This is the analytical calculation algorithm for condenser performance under design condition. There is new and clean, no non-condensable gas, no falling, and no plugging. We calculate the inset of tube thermal convection resistance, outer set of tube thermal convection resistance, thermal conduction resistance of the tube wall, and total thermal resistance. Then we calculate NTU various effectiveness, condenser pressure, and turbine network. We use 2D numerical simulation to obtain the value of condensation heat transfer coefficient on the outside of the tube. We use three non-condensable gas percentage variation, 2%, 5%, and 8%. The geometry used was 2D geometry of several tube condenser that represent the entire arrangement of condenser tube. The result is The result from this simulation is qualitative data. This is the condensation heat transfer coefficient contour and quantitative data. This is the value of condensation heat transfer coefficient on the outside condenser tube. This coefficient value was used to analytical calculation of the outer tube convection thermal resistance in the presence of the non-condensable gas. This is the analytical calculation algorithm for condenser performance on falling condition. We use three falling thickness variation, 2 micrometer, 5 micrometer, and 8 micrometer. At one hand, falling condition make increase on connection thermal resistance, but on other hand, the inset of tube thermal convection resistance will be decreased. So these two opposite will be examined in this paper to find out which one is more significant to condenser performance. This is the analytical calculation algorithm for condenser performance in plugging condition. We use three plugin number variation, 5%, 10%, and 15%. On one hand, plugin condition will be reduce the heat transfer surface area, but on other hand, the plugging condition will increase circulating water velocity, and it is good for heat transfer. So we will study which one is more significant to condenser performance. This is the data of condenser that we use in this paper. We take data from Gresik 200 megawatt steam power plant. This is the qualitative numeric simulation result. It can be concluded that the greater percentage of non-condensable gas, the condensation heat transfer coefficient will decrease. This graph illustrates the value of condensation heat transfer coefficient at points on surface around the tube in the radial direction from 0 degree until 180 degree. It can be concluded that the presence of non-condensable gas in the exhaust turbine would reduce heat transfer in the condenser tube. At 0 degree points, the condensation heat transfer coefficient was the lowest because at that point, the turbine exhaust steam first came into contact with the condenser tube wall and had not yet been condensed. Then at 85 degree points, a gap between the non-condensable gas percentage began to widen, indicating that the condensation process had begun. And at the highest heat transfer coefficient condensation value was at 135 degree points, because at that point, the turbine exhaust steam had changed phase to liquid and there was accumulation of condensate before descending to the condenser tube below it. This is the result of this study. This is the variation condition from new and clean, non-condensable gas condition, volume condition, and plugging condition. In new and clean condition, the power output of turbine is 202 megawatts. Then in non-condensable gas, 8%, the power output turbine decreased until 185 megawatts. In falling 10 micrometers condition, the power output turbine decreased until 192 megawatts. And in plugging condition, 15%, the turbine power output decreased until 174 megawatts. The conclusion of this paper, the greater the percentage of non-condensable gas, the condensation heat transfer coefficient would decrease, and the value of NTU and effectiveness also decrease. The thicker falling layer on the inside of the condenser tube, the value of NTU and effectiveness decrease. The effect of adding thermal conduction resistance due to falling was more dominant than increasing fluid velocity circulating water in terms in influence on the effectiveness of heat transfer. Then, the more the amount of plugging in the condenser tube, the value of NTU and effectiveness decrease. The effect of reducing the heat transfer area due to plugging was more dominant than increasing the speed of circulating water, circulating fluid water in terms of influence on effectiveness of heat transfer. I think that's all. Thank you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.